Okay, done.
All right, so Brett and I have the carb all cleaned up. We have the jets all cleaned up. They were a gunked up mess for sure after sitting for 20 years in that varnish, but we got them all cleaned up. So time to start putting it back together. One thing real quick, when you are cleaning your carb, there's lots of videos out there that really are great instructions as far as being sure that you get all of the passages clean. For example, on this one, you've got your accelerator pump jet here, where you got the coming in here and feeds the bowl, but it also sprays here into your intake on the carb, on the throttle body part. And we could not get anything through this over here. So there's going to be a separate video about this, but basically we had to pull this out, which you don't normally want to do. And then inside there was a needle valve that was stuck. We had to get it out, clean it. Now you can hear it rattling inside, so it's all back together the way it should be. So again, check out a lot of other videos. There's a lot of folks out there that have a lot more experience doing this stuff than I do. So what we're going to start with first, we're going to go with the slow jet, and you can see it's cleaned up. You may not be able to see, but you can see through the holes there, and you can see through the hole there. So we're just going to drop it in, and we're going to take our screwdriver that fits. We're just going to spin it around till it stops, and then just a little snug, and that's it. Next thing we're going to do is put in the needle guide, which is going to go down in here, followed by the emulsion tube. And again, you want to go so that the emulsion tube side is facing this. The beveled side goes down in first. So we're going to just drop that in, shake it around a bit. Just had a jiggle. So you see it's sticking through there now? That's what you want. So we're now going to put our emulsion tube in. With our 8mm, we're just going to give it just a slight crank. There again, just to get it snug. You don't want to overdo it. So now we're going to put in our main jet. We're putting all the original jet sizes back in. Everything is original on the carb, so we want to leave it that way, the way it was from the factory. Put a bladed screwdriver in there that's the correct size. Give it a little turn. That's tight. We've got those three jets in. Let's move on up to our idle jet. So we've got it cleaned up, the spring, the washer, and then the little rubber O-ring on the end. The one, if you remember right, we were an inch and a quarter, or 1 1/4 turns from the bottom. So we're going to drop this back in again, and we're going to take it all the way down gently. So we're at the bottom. So now we need to come up 1 1/4 from there. So we're going to do our quarter, then 1/2. That would be 1 1/4. And we're going to leave it set just like that. I know they make the replacement idle screw external where you can actually spin it, but I had read several things about it being in the carb and eventually coming loose, which we wanted no part of that. All right, so let's move on to the next step, which will be the float. So the next thing we're gonna do is put the float in with the little valve and its hanger out. Kind of see how we're just dropping that right down in there. Always make sure you put it in from the side opposite the arrow when you're putting the pin back in. right? We're just going to put it part way right now because we're going to need to adjust the float height or to check it to make sure it's still okay. So Harley specs say to set this thing. So there's two ways to set it. One way is to set it so this is just about parallel. You see that? Let's see if we can show from this angle. See that little seam of the float itself needs to be just about there when the float is just engaging the little pin. Their actual specs though for Harley is to set this on a 17 or a 15 to 20 degree angle and then do a measurement to see if you're the same from the top to bottom, and if so, then your level is set correct. So we're going to go ahead and set this one on here to start with. And I've made a little jig to set up that I'm at a 17 and a half degree incline so that when I put the carburetor on it, you can see my float now is nowhere close to that. And when I did my measurement, I don't have one of those measurement things. I don't know what you call them. But when I went this way, just to do an approximate measuring, when I first get up here to the top to engage, by the time I get down to the bottom, I'm a good 16th to almost an eighth of an inch off. So we're going to pull the pin back out. We're going to adjust that little tab. We're going to adjust it down a little bit and see if we can get this to come up a little bit. All right, so we're going to go back to this. Setting ourselves at 17 and a half, give or take, whatever we had there before. All right, so we're going to set the deal on there. So it does look like we're much closer now. Now we're still not quite there, but if I do a measurement now from the top, where I'm just almost touching, that's too much. So I get to the bottom, we're still off just a little bit. From the eye, that is looking much better. Let's measure and see. That is looking much closer when I sight that now. It's pretty close. Just about touching there. Still have a little, need to bend that up just again a little bit. It's just amazing how just a little bend one way or the other makes a huge difference.
Many hours later.
And then that side was really right on the mark. Right there, we look pretty good too. So, we've got our float set at the right level. Next thing we're gonna do is pound our little pin back in. Still looking pretty good. So, we're gonna go ahead and take it up. Let's finish the assembly.
All right, time to get the bowl cover back on. I've already put the drain screw in, a washer back in there, O-ring back in. So before you put this on, you're gonna wanna put the little lever on with the new boot. New O-ring that was supplied with Mr. Gasket. James gasket, whatever it's called. Sometimes these want to come out when you tip them upside down. You see what it wants to do there? Just like that. Kind of see it sticking through there now. They are four Japanese industry standard screws back in. Just like that. So we've got the boot all pulled up nice and tight there. And you can see when the plunger will go up and down. So we'll put the new diaphragm in. Remember what that old one looked like? I mean, it looked like crap. All right. Put it in. Sure it stays in the seat. Got our new spring right on top. All right, so we got that. All right, so next. Time for the diaphragm. Only goes in one way, as you can see. I'm going to kind of invert it this way and hold it up from down below as we try to get this to seat into the groove. We don't want to pinch this at all. There you see how it's kind of all setting in there right now. Drop our pin through. Kind of see the action it's got going here. And when someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. All right, there we go. Put the choke cable in right here, and we'll be done. Ready to put it back on the bike. All right, so after about 2 hours, 3 hours worth of our work of cleaning and disassembling and reassembling, and we got the bike, the car ball back together. So next step, put her back on the bike, get her hooked up. Hopefully next time we'll do an initial fire up on it. So stay tuned for that. Meantime, it's been What's Up Bob and Chopper Fett. See you next time. Thanks for joining us.